think about the city in multiple ways and not just through the lens of a couple of sites. You are constantly encountering the unknown or the unexpected in a really great way. I was born in Calcutta. When I first came to New York, I felt like I'd met a long-lost twin brother. This place that's incredibly accepting of people from all over the world. Don't stay in the typical places, I'd say. Maybe stay in Brooklyn or Queens or just, you know, we're a city of neighborhoods. There are things here that are off the beaten path. I think the High Line is a microcosm of New York today. The High Line was a pipe dream. It had 6.5 million visitors last year. It had more visitors than the Statue of Liberty. A friend of mine used to call it a magic carpet ride. You walk through 22 blocks of the city uninterrupted. There's amazing public art. There's great food all around. It's extraordinary. It gives you a vantage point in the city that you've never had before. It's one of the few museums in the world. The entirety of what's on display is open to you as you look up and down. And the way the Guggenheim is meant to be seen is you're supposed to take the elevator to the top and move your way down the spiral. And when you do that, you know, there's always this kind of centrifugal force that kind of grabs you, and you are now in a completely different space. And a knowledge that you're in New York City, but you're in a kind of world apart from New York City, you're kind of in a chapel of sorts, is very, very powerful. Madison Square Garden has a fascinating history. It's moved four times in its existence. It used to be on Madison Square Park. Some of our most significant sporting events, concerts, political events have happened at Madison Square Garden. You can't really live in a bubble here. There is a kind of social friction. You know, you're eyeball to eyeball in the streets and the sidewalks, in the subway. That's welcome because it makes you understand difference.